In 2018, Telecom Namibia suspended four of its executives to pave way for an investigation into a fake contract known as the Canocopy Scandal. Among the implicated executives was the head of legal services, Gina Bice, who has now been cleared and has since returned to office.
We wanted to formally just put it on record that she has been cleared and she has been welcomed home, welcomed back into the enterprise, and her work is being valued. And we really cherish, we appreciate all the work that she has done. And as we have said, it was a due process that has taken place. But I think what is very important to place on record is that this matter has now been closed in as far as Gina's involvement is concerned. We're really happy that the process has gone to its conclusion, and we're happy that she's back at work. She has been welcomed.
Bice says the whole process had a negative effect on her as a person and a professional.
As you all know, there was a lot of publication around the matter. There was a lot of sensation created that may be accurate or not, and not necessarily factual, but it was left open to a lot of public scrutiny where my person and my capabilities specifically were spoken to. I'm very pleased that yes, due process was followed, and I'm very pleased with the outcome that spoke to my tenacity and hard work.
Telecom's chief human resources officer says the matter has now been concluded, considering the remaining three implicated executives are no longer with the company.
On their own accord, then they either went on early retirement and or resigned. And in terms of our internal processes, we regarded that then as having been finalized. Them not being employees anymore, there was no point in pursuing them in terms of the employment relationship.
The Canocopy scandal emanated from a fraudulent lease extension agreement signed between Telecom Namibia and Canocopy in 2016, said to have amounted to $12 million. Timo Andreas, NBC News, Fentok.